Black folks was never equal where I come from. The cops will take you from your people if you ain't careful, son. Martin Luther and Malcolm are in their graves turning over. You a slave to persona. You just chasing the image. Trying to ball shooting shit that you know is way out your range. Living way past your limits. Play it safe, pay attention. I was you once upon a time trying to shine on niggas. Trying to rhyme like Jigga, that's how the white folks get you. Get a nigga a contract and a chain that's bigger than his fucking imagination, then we'll rob that nigga. Niggas all about bitches, could give a damn about business. You'll be pinching every penny, you let them catch your ass slipping. When you trying to survive, who give a fuck about privilege? Section 8 look way different than the houses y'all live in. In a world of demise, why try to speed up the ending? Should've come as a surprise, these crackers here trying to kill us. Your illusion is your own disappointment, can't point at no one else. Know yourself before you destroy yourself. I tried to tell myself I can't trust everybody. Had to understand the type to put a knife in Caesar's neck or put a nail in Jesus' hand.
That's the way that we live it. That's the love of forgiveness in the land of the privilege. Trying to make a percentage, trying to make the world different. Speak up, they gon' kill us. It's a genocide on our kind, they working
against us. We keep on going through the same shit. We keep on going through the same shit.
Cops supposed to protect and serve, they just patrol and control. Now the pigs is killing niggas, shit is out of control. Shit, we killing ourselves, shit is out of control. How does black lives even matter when we kill our own folk? Huey Newton's probably laying in his grave turning over. You a slave to a culture, you just chasing the image. You just trying to fit in, you just wanna be down. You don't have no opinion, you just go with the crowd. Will we ever unite and fight for some shit that'll matter? Shit, I wish Bobby Seale could come and rebirth the Panthers. With a fist in the air, gotta fight for our rights. Cause you can't trust a pig with a badge and some lights. And they wonder why we corrupted and shit. They just trying to shut us up, we won't put up with this shit. I'm saying, put yourself in our shoes. Take a walk in our life. Let your son get murked. Let your pops get life. Satan must be a formula, baby, how they raising hell. I'm trying to sell my flu games cause I ain't fucking with 12. Shit, we all want justice. Fuck that martial law shit. Y'all give a coward a gun and bitch, that's some dumbass shit.
Nigga, you help us, you can help a nigga selfish. Been to hell and now we back where we
we make it to the end, my nigga, ain't no telling. Pass the blood to the reverend, said I see you in heaven. Hey.
Change. So the world is full of people who sit around and demand that everyone else change, while they themselves are unwilling to change. It is not the trees, the grass, or the flowers that change the season, but rather when the season change, it demands a change in the flowers, the trees, and the grass. What am I saying?
What am I saying? From boys to men, it's time to make amends. Popping out challenges straight like a balancer. Working hard until my fingers callous up. You don't know success until you move your parents up. Papa showed me the ropes back when I was a kid. Only right that I do it better than he did. We need wealth, fuck being hood rich. Trying to build my people up like a pyramid. I see my first 10,000 and I got inspired. Cause niggas around here living like they on a wire. No remorse for the shit they did. Leave a nigga smoke like an empty pack of cigs. I'm just trying to do better than it was set up. Cause all my brothers trapping and all my uncles is felons. Just gotta do it different, out here getting to the scratch like Vicky, 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 Vicky.
If you change, it will demand that everybody around you adapt to the new change in you. Change always begins with you. What about wealth? God bless all of us with creative ability. All of us by nature are producers. So God never gives you wealth. He gives us the ability to create wealth. There will always be a demand for your supply. So you have to tap into your creative gift and see what God has blessed you with. And once you recognize that, start producing. And always remember, the enemy to your destiny is procrastination. Get busy and start producing, and there you will find wealth.
Why your bitch still got a Skype? Damn. Think it's time we get a couple things in order. We ain't about to take no orders. Don't act like you fucking know us. We ain't with the back and forward. Money stronger at the tunnel. Don't think you should try to run. I might see hella niggas on the stage, but we ain't performance. Janky, I done hypnotized. Waving their hands at the side. Know this sleazy down the slide. No Nike D down the slide. If I let her spend the night, she think that she won the prize. Dollar signs be on my mind. Dollar signs be on my. I'ma cook it up and make the streets go whoa whoa. Got the recipe, phone up the team like whoa whoa. Might just cup your bitch, do it with ease like scoop scoop. This how it sound when you wake the beast like whoa whoa.
I'ma keep on working till I buy what I want. Caught what my arm want. Family get some songs. I'ma keep on working my Alfredo Parmesan. Bread Italian. Babies grow the dons, live extravagant. Nice is coming young. Little niggas is robbing shit, so you can't trust these fucking bums. Let me get some money, I can't call it flipping funds. I sleep in schedule, I be up until the sun. Sure, we got the boule for the drink, we on the run. Booty shaking, percolate, she gyrate when they cute to play. I dodge the bitch, I'm working, bae. I hit you when we drop the tape. Almost dropping, hold away. Don't touch my fam, no fucks, no play.
I'ma cook it up and make the streets go whoa, whoa. Got the recipe, bone up the team like whoa, whoa. Might just cuff your bitch, do it with ease like scoop, scoop. This how it sound when you wake the beast like whoa. Where she at? I'm about to pull up. Shoot my shot like Chauncey Billups. I think I just dodged a bullet. She must think a nigga stupid. I know I don't see no future. I know I can't be a lover. Baby, you know I'm a hustler. Trying to get that diamond cluster on my motherfucking knuckle. I know I can't ever buckle. I know I can't be a buster. Spread the money like it's mustard. Rockin' chains on Harley Tucker. Might just let the diamonds tussle. Marijuana crumbled on the vinyl. Stevie Wonder. Used to scam. Used to front a nigga grams. To the mirror and I still see who I am. Made the paper stack, it got me feeling like a man. Your lady digging that, want me to get up in them yams. I'ma cook it up and make the streets go whoa, whoa. Got the recipe, bone up the team like whoa, whoa. Might just cuff your bitch, do it with ease like scoop, scoop. This how it sound when you wake the beast like
like, whoa,
think it's time we get a couple things in order. We ain't about to take no orders. Don't act like you fucking know us. We ain't with the back and forward. Money strong, it had to turn up. Don't think you should try to run up. Might see hella niggas on the stage, but we ain't performers.
Nigga. Rip. Oh, damn. I forgot the word, nigga. Carlo, go back, nigga.
Don't play with me.
Hey.
Brainstorm. Ooh. I'm about to go airborne. You're looking at a guy in rare form. The shit I'm spitting, I should probably get the chair for.
Hold on.
Wait, I fell in like a master B. I got the master key. I pull up to the master suite. This life was meant for me. What kind of master dinner while I'm eating mac and cheese? A model snacking on my dick is zero calories. I was a thief and that's Vanessa in my past life. Where I'm from, that's like my city's favorite pastime. Sticking to the cash flow, now I'm back on them hoes. The way it came back, would think I sold crack to them hoes. You spending money like it's going out of style.
Nigga.
I can tell you never had shit, you be acting like a child. Hear these rappers, I just laugh and crack a smile. All that ice you rocking got you watered down. I swear the game ain't been the same since Pimp C went home. Y'all just some old ass rappers fucking young ass hoes. But never mind, I'ma leave that there alone. Just keep it real and let the fakers get exposed. Yeah, they don't want it, they ain't ready for me. They don't want it, hell no, they ain't ready for me. Recognize a fraud when you see one. Flexing, trying to put on a facade for the camera. Guess your occupation's perpetrating for a dollar. Must be hard providing for your kids and baby mama. I'm the golden child, I keep it polished, never tarnished. Bitch, I got that flavor, JJ Fat, that supersonic. Confident in who I am, so I don't fairy tale. My life and this music, do you see the parallels? You look mad suspicious, I know you got bad intentions. Tryna straddle fences, nigga, you gon' split your britches. Tried to tell them keep it silent, niggas never listen. All because we stayed the same when all y'all tried to switch it. Money on the way, followed by a train of bitches. Laying in my bed at night, I'm having visions. Went to sleep and had a dream about a Mercedes G-Wagon. Pull up to a mansion, diamond shining, so fluorescent. They don't want it, they ain't ready for me. They don't want it, hell no, they ain't ready for me. They don't want it, they ain't ready for me. They don't want it, hell no, they ain't ready for me. You need the real, not the bootleggers. I mean for real, damn, you can do better. You need the real, not the bootleggers. I mean for real, you can do better.
What is up, everybody? We got Tut in the waiting room right now. Welcome to the stream. So happy that some of you guys are here. Happy for anybody that's here. I'm super excited for this stream tonight. This one is really important to me, really big. This is a milestone one for me. I'm super excited to introduce you guys to Tut. His music means a lot to me, and we're going to get to know him a little bit tonight. So appreciate him coming on, and we're going to admit him into the room real quick, and then we'll get this thing started. So give me 1 second, and I'm going to get this thing set up. We're just getting this thing set up over here and we'll be all good to go. I'll be right back, guys.
What's up, man? Yep. Yes, sir. I'm finna get you set up with Tut here.
All the audio is good to go. Right, let's see. Let me see. Let me, guys, guys in the stream, let me know that you can hear Tut okay. And then let me know that you can hear me okay. And we should be good to go. So, yeah, man, welcome to the stream. I was just telling you, you know, I'm super thankful for you coming on. Your music played at mine and my wife's wedding. I've been following you for a while. Your music means more to me than I can put into words. So this is a milestone interview for me and an awesome conversation I've been looking forward to having. So it really just means a lot to have you on. So how's your night going so far?
It's good, man. I'm just chilling with the homies, bro. My boy Zay, he in town, so
nice.
We just kicking it over here at this folks' crib right now, just talking shit, swallowing spit. You know how it go.
Well, you had a birthday recently too, right?
Yeah, in December, December 19th. That's my birthday. Yeah.
Okay, so almost a month now. Nice, nice. Well, happy belated. Hope it was a good time.
Yeah, it was lit. We went to the club and shit.
Hell yeah. Saw the pictures on Instagram. It looked like a good time.
Yeah, it was lit. We had sex and shit. It was crazy. So.
Hell yeah. Right off the bat, what does hip-hop mean to you, and why is it so important?
I mean, just hip-hop is like, oh, no, man. Like, I guess my relation to hip-hop, I guess, is like growing up and riding around with my dad and, like, him just putting me on, like, a whole bunch of, like, old shit, like, Public Enemy, Slick Rick. He even put me on like one of my favorite rappers, Biggie Smalls. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it was like a bunch of rappers he put me on, bro. Like, but like, I started to study them, and then from there, like, and then like being around my cousin Jerry, he used to, you know, just be playing everything. He had this boombox in his room and, like, all the Tupac posters and, like, all that shit. So, you know, like, that was just, like, I guess, like, my gateways into music. And then, like, I just started falling in love with it more and more. So by the time I was, like, 13 or, like, some shit like that, my dad took me to this restaurant. It was, like, a Jamaican cuisine restaurant. And it was ran by this dude named Big Jeezy. Like, I guess around that way, he was, like, a known dope runner, like, whatever, in the streets. Like, you know what I'm saying? And he basically had, like, a studio in the back of the Jamaican restaurant. And then asked me, basically show me the shit. He didn't even ask me shit. He showed me the shit, and then it was, like, an engineer sitting back there smoking the Black and Mild. So then when I go inside, and then I'm like, yo, can I record something? And I'm like, bro, like, me being a little nigga, like, of course he say yeah and shit like that. And my dad, he was, like, in the front, like, talking, you know what I'm saying, to the guy or whatever. So I ended up recording, like, my first song in the back of that restaurant. And then I think a few months later, they ended up getting raided. And then all of the studio equipment, he had gave it to my pops. So it, like, ended up downstairs in, like, my basement. And, like, that's really how I just really started getting into music and, like, just being inspired by, like, people like, you know, B.I.G., Juvenile, like, Missy Elliott, like, long-ass list of people, bro. Like, just being inspired, Outkast, all that shit.
That's a crazy story, man. I just found this out today by watching an interview you did back in 2015. What TUT actually stands for, the understood truth. And, like, everything came full circle because my brand is called Talkin' Truth, and everything is, like, I got truth tattooed on my arm. Like,
it's crazy. It's crazy.
It was, like, and I told my wife today, and she just went, it makes sense. It just makes so much sense that, like, yeah, we fell in love with this music so fast. Like, it was so cool to, like, have that connection immediately.
Yeah, definitely. We was actually me and Isaiah, we was finna actually call a group YGTUT. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And, like, I ended up saying it on this song called Perk Perk. And then, like, I basically said, bitch, I'm YGTUT or whatever. And then, like, after that, that's when, like, they was like, hey, bro, like, that shit, Slick should be your name. That shit stick. So then, like, I go back home, and then I'm telling my moms about the shit. And, like, she like, yeah, whatever. But then she, like, go tell my, like, nanny about the shit. Or I call her my nanny, but it's my grandmama, her mama. She telling her about the shit. And then my granny, like, oh, damn, that's crazy, because they used to call his great-granddaddy Tut. And she was like, get the fuck out of here. Like, you know what I'm saying?
So, yeah.
You know, I guess, like, it was just, like, meant to be. Like, shit like that, I guess it was just, like, written. That shit was bound to happen.
Word. Kind of a follow-up question to that. Why is it important to stay truthful to yourself and what you believe in?
It's important to stay truthful to yourself because, like, a lot of niggas out here already be fabricating, and they be doing a bunch of fake shit. Ain't nobody really solid. A lot of people don't be loyal. People pretend like they for you, and they don't really be there for you. You know what I'm saying? So, like, it's a... best to just be yourself and, like, just show your true intentions, like, because that way people can, like, really appreciate you for, like, who you really are, you know what I'm saying? And not, you know, like, just this facade of, like, you know, what everybody tries to be. Like, I ain't never really pretended to, like, be anything more or less than, like, what I really am. So, like, it's just like that for me. I don't like being around fake people. I don't like associating with fake people. If I feel like I can't trust you, or if you're not really for me, then I don't want you anywhere around me. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I don't feel like you got my best interest, then I don't want nothing to do with you. Like, it's just, like, important to be true and let people know your true intentions, because, like, when you don't, man, like, that shit just, like, causes for disaster, bro. Like, you know?
Word, definitely. When was the first time you realized that your art can have an impact on other people in, like, a really positive way?
I don't know, man. Like, I guess, like, when I seen what Preacher Son did, and then I was like, okay, this is real crazy. But I don't even think I got it like that then, honestly. Like, I was just more so like, okay, I don't like everybody thinking that I'm a motherfucking, like, just trying to, like, relate this preacher son, like, narrative to me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So,
like, I think, like, in a way, I tried to, like, shun away from it, like, because it was just, like, too much at the time. But, like, now, like, I've learned, like, how to embrace it. Like, you know, like, years later and shit like that. But, like, off top, yeah, it was just basically that.
To piggyback in a little bit on Preacher Son, and to ask a little question about that, did you, when you were making it, or like when it was ready to come out, did you know, or did you have a feeling like, man, this is going to impact some people, or was it just kind of, we're going to throw it out there, see what happens type situation, and then it like blew up on you?
Yeah, that's basically what happened. We was just like, yeah, in the studio recording and stuff like that, and like already kind of like motivated seeing like what was going on with my boy situation and shit like that, him getting signed to TDE and stuff. So like I was just you know, in a mode with my people, and like we was just in Chattanooga doing our thing, and then we just had all the resources, everything was just coming like at that time, that just made everything like easy. Like if we needed these instruments, like we knew somebody who knew how to play them instruments, so all we had to do was tell them to pull up and the rest is easy. You know what I'm saying? It was all right there. Like,
hell yeah,
we didn't have to really try.
Word. What does it mean to be from Chattanooga to you?
That's home, bro. Like I wear that shit proudly. You know what I'm saying? Like, word. I just love the fact that like us, like being coming from a place like Chattanooga, Tennessee, bro, like where a lot of people don't know about it. If you really think about it, since Bessie Smith, bro, we haven't had like a musician like to really come up out of here. And like anybody else who really did come up out of here didn't come up out of here. They like moved. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's where they got their start at or whatever.
Yeah.
But like, so like I wear it really proudly to like be from here, to be somebody who like legit came up from the out of Chattanooga, like was in the, like here when my shit popped up. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And I'm my first 100K, I was in chat. You know what I'm saying? So like, it's shit like that I don't know, man. I feel like we're innovators, like from where we come from, and like just like doing something that has never been seen before. So like I just want to like keep on trying to like make history and like hopefully put the battery in other people back, I guess, to, you know, I guess do the same.
Word. Can you just talk a little bit about maybe the origin of the house and who's all involved with that and why it's so special?
Origin of the house, like, man, it's basically a collective of producers, rappers, like you know, just innovators, like in general, like entrepreneurs in general, like, you know, like that's basically what the house is. And it started with myself, Isaiah Rashad, and Mikey D. We was all growing up to MTSU together, and we was like rapping, making music and shit like that. And I think we just like came up, like we was finna call it something else, like Flight House or some shit like that, but we dropped the flight and like just was like, nigga, we the house. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, like, that shit stuck. And then we started saying that at shows. And then, like, it just stuck, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's awesome. What do you like to do outside of music for fun? If you're not doing anything for music at all on a day, like, what do you find yourself doing?
Smoking weed, watching television, eating good food, traveling. Well, normally when I travel, it somehow turns into work. yeah, man. Like, I it's a lot of shit. I don't know. Like, I don't do much, but I do a lot at the same time, bro. But, like, as of late, I really been locked in, bro. So, like, I don't really know. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't really had to, like, just chill and, you know, do shit. But I know for sure, like, if it's a good TV show on that I like, I'm a tap in and watch that, and I'm a smoke. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Yeah, I ain't trying to like promote like all that shit, even though I'm gonna smoke through this whole interview.
But. Hell yeah. I got a little, I didn't have enough to roll anything up, so I got a little bowl pack, but we're gonna work with what we got for right now.
Yeah.
Let's see. I feel like watching your interviews through your music, through everything that I've gathered, you have a very go with the flow personality. Like whatever comes at you, you're gonna deal with it. How does that help you work on yourself as a person?
I don't know what you mean by that.
I don't know. I feel like fighting change can sometimes stop people from growing or from making progress in a certain situation. So I feel like just kind of going with the flow allows you to deal with change a little bit differently. Because like for me, I don't know, I feel like I fight change sometimes and I got to kind of catch myself and just like deal with the situation a little bit better.
Yeah, I feel like at a time, like I didn't embrace change. And I was just like used to what I knew and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But like, I guess like just hard times and stuff like that, I guess made me like a person to, I guess, like go with the flow and like just bounce back or like just like move accordingly to like what's going on. Like, because like, I don't know, bro. Like, I done kind of seen it all from like every kind of angle. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, as far as like how this game go, like I done seen managers like who act like they really for you and then like they don't be there for you and then, you know, like just go ghost on you, bro, and then just like leave you in a situation where you got to figure out your shit for yourself. You know what I'm saying? And like, I've seen that with producers, engineers, all kind of shit. Mm. So it's like, and it's not like, oh, like it's no bad blood or no kind of shit like that. I understand like people be going through shit like in their own personal lives that they don't really, you know, want to talk about, you know, whatever. So like, I think that shit just taught me like, okay, bro, like, I got this vision. It's the vision. It's like what we trying to make happen. So like, am I gonna let somebody stop me from getting to my destiny? Am I gonna let somebody prevent me from like letting my dream happen or whatever? Or am I gonna buckle down and do what the fuck I need to do to get to where I want to be? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So like, it's really like that simple for me. It's a sink or swim mentality, really. You know what I'm saying? So it's like a go with the flow in a sense like that. Like, yeah, I'm gonna go with the flow. Like, if it's like whatever's going on, if it's a beat or whatever, if you're talking about it in that sense, like, yeah, like I just whatever it calls for, that's what I'm trying to bring to the table. But like in real life situations, because that's where my mind went when you asked me that, like, yeah, like you going through like trial and error and like understanding what kind of different personalities and people, like egotistical ass motherfuckers, narcissistic motherfuckers that you run into, even though everybody has to admit that they have a bit of narcissism in themselves. Like, but like when people like shit get out of hand and stuff like that, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, it just lets you like it bring you another angle and it show you how to move different. So mm-hmm. like you don't want to go through that same shit again. You know what I mean?
Definitely. Kind of speaking on another, it was like the tattoo video that you did with Audio Mac. You said one of your favorite movies inspired one of the tattoos. And one of the inspirations behind it was love overpowering hate. So how do you find yourself making love overpower hate on a day-to-day basis?
Not trying to get no get back on motherfuckers, which I know I really deserve some get back on your ass. Like just really acting in love and compassion, like showing compassion, you know what I'm saying? And empathy, like practicing empathy with people who like don't have the same point of view as me, like, and just like trying to be patient. Like, and I know I'm not like, I don't got all this shit figured out by any means, like, but like the point is that you try, like you actually put forth a constant effort to like try not to like retaliate or try to be compassionate or try to have empathy or try not to lack empathy, like when you're dealing with people and understand that like everybody got their own walk of life and not everybody go through the same shit as you and everybody got their own problems. So it's like, you know, like everything don't deserve a response. Everything doesn't, you know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like social media makes everybody think they have to respond nowadays too.
Yeah, but it's like when you moving right, Brian, you moving in love and you moving like, you know, in your purpose and shit like that, you don't really got time for that. Like, you know what I'm saying? I say let God deal with it. You know what I mean? Like, because it ain't no point in me trying to get back at you, bro, because like all that's doing is like me wasting time getting my bag of focusing on my mission or like what I'm trying to do. You know what I'm saying? So yeah. Like, I don't got time for that. I'm trying to get to where I'm going, bro. Like, so like, shit. All right, fool, you can have that. You want it? All right, bet. You got that. I'm over here. I'm just going to like win. You know what I'm saying? I'm just going to do what I need to do and like stay focused and win, nigga. Like, fuck that shit, nigga. Like, okay, you thought you was going to kill me. I'm going to come back 10 times harder. And then I'm just going to fuck it up. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah.
I know people, they probably like, oh, nigga, chill out, bro. Like, you don't drop on. Nigga, if all of y'all knew, bro, for the last few years, bro, like, I was, you know, working on albums and shit like that. And, like, shit started out, like, just because, like, people weren't solid. Like, you know what I'm saying? People mm-hmm. wasn't true people. You know what I'm saying? Like, all these questions that you ask me, it's like, that's like an answer, like, for all of them, really. Like, it's just like, that shit just taught me so much, bro. Like, putting your trust, and it's like, it ain't no bad blood, but it just taught me, and it helped me grow in a way, like, such to, like, where, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, people, you put your trust in the people, and then, like, they don't come through on you, bro, then they, like, just make you, either you gonna fold, or you gonna be resilient, nigga. Like, so, like, which one is it gonna be? You know what I mean? Like, which one is it gonna be? You just gonna sit? I'm like, you gonna come back harder. I'm gonna come back harder. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Dang, I definitely had to learn that lesson recently. I had a bad interaction that kind of made me stop doing the streams for 3 or 4 months because I had a bad interaction with an artist, and I just had to, man, that just having this conversation with you is gonna help me just keep that in the forefront of my head. So this is dope.
That's what they want to see, bro. They want to see you quit. They want to see you. They want to be like, oh, yeah, that nigga couldn't do this shit without me. Nah, nigga. I can still do it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, niggas, you didn't make me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so how you gonna break me? You know what I mean?
Man, hell yeah. It's kind of cool you mentioned growth, too, in that last answer, because the next four questions I got for you, I kind of like to introduce you to the brand a little bit. The tree is really prevalent. It's within the logo. It stands for growth, and there's four different parts of the tree. The first part is the roots at the bottom, and they stand for the core values that you've got in life. So what would a couple core values for you be?
If you say you're going to do something, do it. Be a man of your word. Do what you need to do so you can do what you want to. Just, like, show empathy. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's just, like, I don't know. Like, it's a lot of lessons like that. Like, I done got along the way. Like, don't put your destiny in nobody else's hands. Like, it's a lot of shit that I just learned, you know what I'm saying, across the way. I could be here talking about that forever, but, like, just, like, I guess just, you know, be a compassionate, empathetic ass person. Move genuine, and don't try to take advantage of nobody. And, like, just be a solid person, bro. Don't fold on your people. Take care of your people. If you say you're gonna do something, do that shit. You know what I'm saying? Bottom line, because, like, it's a lot of fake niggas out here. It's enough fake niggas out here. It's enough people out here that's not solid. It's enough people who don't be 10 toes. It's enough people, like, on bullshit. So it's like, dare to be different, motherfucker. Dare to actually be a solid person. Dare to actually follow through on that shit that you said you was going to do. Be different enough to actually, that plan that you was working on, be different enough to actually, like, put that shit into action and, like, be successful with it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, actually take the time and, like, don't quit on yourself. Like, you know what I'm saying? So,
definitely.
Yeah.
I'm not going to ask the second question because you've already touched on it a couple times. The second part is the body of the tree, and it just represents the people that you keep around you. I mean, I get you might have a follow-up to it, but I know you said you didn't release music for a few years because you had to get shit right at home. And, I mean, you've mentioned it before. There's people that won't come through for it, and you got to do your own stuff and go from there. So, the body of the tree is just simple. It represents the people that you keep around you because it helps hold you up a little bit. So.
Right, I had a whole album, bro. Like, that was ready to go. Like, we couldn't put that motherfucker out because the motherfucker literally wouldn't give us the stems, like the final mixes that we needed to, like, get everything. Like, I'm talking about the whole shit, like the whole skits, features. I'm talking about, I got Young Nudie on that motherfucker, Big Rip, Starlito. I had to, like, put that whole album on ice.
Damn.
But I'm going to get shit right because, like, that's really family. Like, the person, like, I don't know. People be going through their own shit. So I don't fault him necessarily, bro. Like, you know what I mean? But it's just like, damn, bro. Like, we really could have did some crazy shit, like, 2 years ago, nigga. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah. Let's see. Third part of the tree going up is the branches, and the branches represent the experiences that you've had in life. They help make you and everything. So what would you say is the most, or the experience that you're most proud of so far that your music has brought you?
What's the last end of that question?
Just the best experience, basically, that your music has brought you so far.
Therapy? Yeah, man. Me making music is just, like, real therapeutic. The process, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I don't write. So, like, when I go into the studio, majority of the time, unless I'm just in a good mood and I'm just trying to make a bop, like, would be on my... And even in those times, bro, like, I still be spilling real. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, but I like going to a studio session and just being able to, like, to whatever's going on, like, I got going on in my life, like being able to make a song to help me get through that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Word. Last part of the tree is the leaves. The leaves that come off the branches are the lessons that you take from, you know, the experiences that you've had in life. So is there a lesson maybe that you learned early in life from like a family member that sticks with you more than some others?
Yeah, my dad taught me a lot, man. Just like, don't stop. Like, whatever you're doing, like, don't stop. Like, I watched him a lot, like, growing up. Like, he's a preacher. But, like, I just watched how resilient he was. Like, people, like, try to, like, push him out or, like, bad shit had happened. But, like, you know, he wouldn't never let it get to him. Like, he'll understand, like, the purpose of what he's doing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, just understanding that it's a bigger purpose than you. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's why you do what you do. You know what I'm saying? It's because it helps other people and it impacts and other people. Like, you know what I'm saying? We're here to be helpers. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I think just like him in general, like just watching him has just been a life lesson for me. Like, because it just taught me a little better how I want to deal with people, what I do and what I don't want to be. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's cool you mentioned purpose, because one of my favorite lines of yours of all time is on Sunday service. A lot of people doing things on purpose, but without a purpose. Like, the first time I heard that, I was just like, whoa, all right, that's next level, and that's going to stick with me for a long time. So why is purpose so important when you're making decisions?
Because if you don't move with no intention, bro, like, how the fuck you know where you're going? Like, how you know, like, what you're doing? Like, what's the purpose of what you're doing? You just doing some shit just to do it, or you want to get somewhere with it? It's like, take music, for example. A lot of niggas, like, come and they make music, but, like, a lot of music don't be saying shit. So it's like, results in a lot of niggas just saying the same shit. Mm-hmm. So it's like, what's the purpose of everybody doing? Now, I understand that we trying to get a bag, but, like, are you just trying to get a bag? Or, like, are you here because you got a voice? Like, are you here, like, because you trying to impact somebody? Are you here because you want people to be like you? Are you here because you feel like you got something to say? Like, you know what I mean? Like,
what was the first time you realized that like some of the stuff you're doing is not as like just you as like a vehicle and like kind of God speaking through? I think you spoke on that a little bit in the DJ Booth interview from 2019. When was one of the first times you realized that it's like the help of God from you giving that message to other people?
Man, I realized that I'm back, bro. I realized that I'm back, like, because I talked to God, man. I got a real relationship with God. Like, not to be corny or, like, sound preachy and all that, like, but, like, I really talked to God. I really believe in manifesting. I really believe that your life can be whatever you want it to be. All you got to do is, like, speak it into existence and actually work towards it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, putting the daily work to, like, actually become what you want to become, and you'll be there. Like, I'm exactly who I wanted to be, like, when I was, like, 13 or 12 or, you know, 11. Like, I'm that now, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like that's because I've seen it then, I visioned it, and I worked towards it for, like, a long amount of time until, like, it started to pay off, you know what I'm saying? And it's still, like, a lot of work to do, like, but just, like, you know, us knowing, the fact of knowing, like, I'm actually doing this, like, and now I'm, like, trying to solidify, like, I'm actually here, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's all it is.
Word. Let's see, how do you pick yourself up on a day that you're not feeling the best? Is there any way that you can get yourself back in the groove other than you just go in the booth, or is there anything outside of music that you go to that helps you?
Yeah, like, I like to listen to music. I like to, like, just jam out and, like, listen to, like, reggae vibes. I like Tim's a lot. Wizkid, Burna Boy. It's a few others. Like, I forgot dude's name, but it's a song called La La. Like, but just shit that, like, I don't know, just give you good energy, good vibes. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Nothing like too crazy, like, because, like, I feel like a lot of people, when they be having like bad vibes, they like try to go do stuff to, you know, I guess they really be negative. You know what I'm saying? They really don't be anything good for, you know, I guess your spirit, I guess, or your person is just like stuff that I guess is like instant gratification that make you feel good in the moment. But like it don't really do nothing for you. Like, you know what I'm saying? It don't really benefit you at all. So,
yeah.
Like, I'm just trying to, like, I guess, jam out, listen to some good music, or like watch a good movie, or, you know, like just smoke a ton of weed till I feel better.
That's usually my go-to, just smoke a bunch of weed. Usually works. Let's see, how long do you have... how long do you have to let an album sit before you can consider it a classic? Because Preacher Son is, I mean, people are still talking about it, you know, 7 years later. It just turned 7 this month. So I've had this debate with a couple different people. So what's your opinion on that? How long has an album got to sit there before you can call it a classic?
I feel like if it's just something that you go back to over time, like repeatedly, not just like one time, then like it might be, you know, considered a classic in a way. Like, not just pertaining to like Preacher Son, but like just in general, like, or like something that when you can hear it years later and it still impacts you as if you heard it like the first day it dropped type shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like timeless music, something that's timeless. I feel like that's what makes music classic. It's like if it's timeless, like I can listen to this shit forever. Like, you can still bump Michael Jackson Butterflies today, and that shit's still gonna bump the same way. It's a lot of Michael Jackson songs that he made, like 1980s, like 90s, early 2000s, probably even in the 70s. Nigga, this nigga was doing this shit for a long time. Like, but it's shit like that just be timeless. Like, that's classic to me.
What's a couple of projects to you that are front to back classics, like that you could listen to from front to back, no problem, just go tos?
Jay-Z, Reasonable Doubt, Michael Jackson, Living on the Wall, and Thriller too, of course.
Mm.
Preacher Son. Biggie Smalls, Ready to Die. It might be a couple skips in there, though. Shout out to Biggie. But, like, I don't know. Like, he put out two solid bodies of work, like Life After Death and, like, Ready to Die. Like, it was, like, pretty flawless. And I feel like in the time, like, I got on that shit, like, way later on. But I feel like in the time, like, that was, like, You bumping that shit the whole way through. You bumping that shit the whole way through. You got to think. Yeah, Juicy, Warning, goddamn. Bro, it was so many, bro. It Hypnotized, like, yeah.
Let's see. One of the questions I had was kind of about the pandemic. It's brought a lot of terrible situations to a lot of different people, but what's something that maybe... that it's helped you with? Like, for me, it made me do these interviews. Like, I had no plan to do interviews with Zoom or none of that shit, and then I stopped doing all the concert recaps and going to concerts and studio stuff, and I had to find something to do. So, like, I the Talkin Truth interviews were born from the pandemic. So what's something that maybe the pandemic helped you with, or is a bright spot from the pandemic for you?
Yeah, we just get more focused and, like, lock in more. I have more time to, like, lock in and, like, just figure out my whole shit, like what I wanted to do with, like, music, where I wanted to take this shit, how to bounce off of that album, like, that I couldn't put out, you know what I'm saying? Like, and, like, turn around and, like, produce another album and then another album, like, be like, okay, this is how we're gonna roll it out, this, like, how we gonna do it. So it just, I guess, made me, like, become more resilient of a person and, like, I guess, just learn how to really play the game, like, how to really run this shit. like really know like how to play other part, other roles, and just, you know, like how a basketball player like LeBron can probably go in there, he could like probably be at like small forward or whatever, and then or shooting guard and moving the shooting guard, and he could probably even play center or post, like whatever, like point guard, like. So, like, that's the same way I feel. Like, I learned other roles to play, like, in the pandemic.
That wasn't
rap.
That's fire. What's your favorite one to make some... What's your favorite way to make somebody smile?
Tell a joke. I'm a goofy-ass person. I like just, like, tell jokes and, like, you know, just fuck around. Like, just shoot the shit. Like, just... say shit sometimes for the fuck of saying it, like.
Yeah, you like any stand-up comedians at all, like watch any stand-up on Netflix or YouTube or anything?
I gotta tap back in. I've been like, I think the last comedian that I watched that was funny, and it was like older stand-ups of his, but like Hannibal Buress, he's pretty funny to me. And I mean, of course, like Richard Pryor, Mike Epps, Kevin Hart, shit, bro. It's a lot of people, bro. Like, I like funny shit, bro. Like, I be watching 85 South, like, all that shit. Like, you know what I mean? So.
Word. Is there anything that you can tell us about the new project coming up? Like, maybe some stuff that's inspired it, or, like, just anything you're comfortable with letting us know about the new music coming up?
Yeah, we got a new album on the way. It's called In My Head, and, like, basically... it's like just trying to take you like on this. I'm trying to take the listener into my head on my perspective, how I view things. Just like, I guess how I process things like in general, and like just trying to, I guess, let the listeners in on like what's really been going on these last couple of years, and like just like how I've been dealing with it, and you know, just trying to speak about it from every angle, like just in my head, like my real thoughts, really, like just uncensored, just out there, man, just letting that shit all hang out. So like, I feel like y'all gonna be excited about this album. I did it with Jared. He's this producer out of Chattanooga y'all finna get hip to. He also produced Dollar Signs, by the way, but real homegrown, like, bro, is a real phenomenal musician, bro. Like, he plays so many instruments, like, and like we just locked in and like just made some vibes. I can't wait for y'all to hear this album. We shooting videos. We just shot a video last week. We shooting another video starting tomorrow. And y'all can expect this album probably, I'll say, in the next month or so.
Word. What goes into making music videos? Are you coming up with a lot of the storyline for that? Or do you have like somebody else to like help you with the creative part of that? I've always felt like that's gotta be one of the most difficult things to do. Like, cause I could I'm thinking of songs and I could never plan out like a storyboard for a music video in my head.
Yeah, I'm fucking with my man Daniel. Shout out to Daniel. And him, yeah, we just sit down and I come to him with an idea, and it'll be like a pretty elaborate idea, and then like we'll talk about it for a few days, and then like he'll trim it down a little bit, you know, to like what he know he could do, like, and then like we'll go from there. Like, you know what I'm saying? So yeah. But yeah, I definitely have been involved, I guess, a lot with I guess coming up with these treatments and stuff. And like Daniel, he's definitely like the GOAT, bro. Like he just shot Dollar Signs. He shot the Long Day video. I don't know if you remember that, but he a real solid guy, man. And he shot Bootleggers too. So we did a few things together, but that's who I've been locked in with. Real solid guy. Every like we just got a good chemistry.
Hell yeah. That's awesome. Let's see. I ask every artist this. This is the last question I usually ask everybody. What does truth mean to you?
Truth means to me, like, just out of honesty, bro. Like, just, like, uncensored, like, this just what it is, flat out. Like, regardless of, like, how you feel about it, like, you know what I mean? Like, this is just flat out, like, what it is, like. I ain't trying to spare nobody. I ain't trying to save nobody, flat out. This is fact. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what truth is to me.
Hell yeah. Well, shit, man. I super appreciate you coming on. Again, it means a world to me. And hopefully, you know, if you got something else coming up, welcome you back on the show anytime you want to come back on. And shit, man, yeah. I hope you enjoyed your time on your Talkin' Truth interview.
Yeah, thanks for having me. Oh yeah, we got like some collective shit coming out real soon too. So like, I just wanted to get out there. So y'all expect that real soon too. So.
Word, that's exciting.
Yeah, so like we ain't just got an album coming, we got a few things coming.
Let everybody know what the house is up to, not just Tut.
Yeah, it's gonna be a lit 2022, man. Tap in.
Hell yeah. Hey, shout out Foolish, thanks for coming through. You said great interview as always. Thanks for coming through the interview, and thank you again, Tut. It really means a lot, and hope you have a good rest of the night. And yeah, man, hopefully we'll see you again, and I can't wait for the new music. And last before we go, I saw the tweet about the Preacher Son vinyls. Are those coming back soon?
Yeah, man, we were supposed to release them today, bro, but I've been like super busy, so I think we were like waiting on one thing from the people over there that's printing up the vinyls, and then we'll like let them go and like do pre-orders and stuff like that. But
nice. I know people have been waiting and looking for them for a while. I paid almost $300 for one off a resale from France or Sweden or something. I was like, we had to have it. I told my wife, I was like, look, they listed one, it's $280. Like, I never see this one listed anywhere. Are you cool? And she was like, yeah, no, it's fine. And I was like, whoa, okay, it's cool. Let's get it. We got it. So yeah, we had to buy off the third black market, but you know, it was worth it. We got one.
Yeah, for sure. I'm glad you got it though, bro. I hope you enjoy it, man. Like, thank you for like, you know.
Oh yeah. I'll have to come through a show sometime and get it signed or something.
I got you. Absolutely, man.
Appreciate it. Awesome. Well, again, have a good night, man. Take it easy, and stay safe out there, man. We'll see you later.
Thanks, man. You have a good one, too.
Later.
Thanks for having me.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
All right, one.
Hey, that was Tut. That's from Chattanooga, man. Oh, that was awesome. It was really cool to see a lot of the stuff that I've thought about his music come full circle, and some of the questions that I asked him tonight, and hopefully you guys learned a little something about Tut, and hopefully you'll go check out some more of his music. Obviously, you know, we were talking about Preacher Son there for a little bit at the end. That's the album that he is most known for. But he's got other music out that is really, really good too. He's got a project called 423, I believe, or it's something like that with other house guys. And then he's got the IOU out as well. That project is really dope. And now you heard he's got In My Mind, I think it was titled. We'll have to go back and check the video again. But he's got another album coming out really soon. Videos being shot for it and everything. So, man, I can't wait to hear some new Tut. That's super exciting. Again, appreciate everybody that rolled through. I hope you guys are liking the new look of the stream. I hope it ran smoothly today. It looks like I only lost 117 total frames across the stream. So if give me a quick little, if you guys are still here, just let me know if it did run smoothly tonight. Just give me like a thumbs up or yeah, ran smooth. Just let me know if it did run okay. It looks like the stats on my end are a lot better than the last couple streams that we've done. Hey, thanks, Drew. I appreciate it. Thank you for stopping by. It means a lot, man. I really appreciate it. Anybody that stopped by, it always means a lot to me. I'm learning to do this for myself a little bit more recently. You know, I turned off the viewer count. I don't know how many people are viewing at any given time. I'm not focused on, you know, doing this shit for money or fucking any other people other than myself. So I just really appreciate everybody that rolls through whenever you do. And you know, we're gonna continue to schedule some more dope interviews, bring you some more hip-hop content, talk some more truth, and you know, call it a day. I think I'm gonna try to get I'm working on getting a computer so I can up the stream game a little bit more. I hope we can add some Call of Duty to the stream or something. Maybe me and Chop Stock, we play Call of Duty all the time. So dude, people spamming on the chat. I wish I gotta figure out how to like. Hey, Rosie Bandom, there we go. Good stuff. That's perfect. That's why I made you a moderator, Rosie. Thank you so much. I didn't even have to teach her how to do that, guys. She just banned the spammer like on her own. That was all Rosie. Like, that was impressive. Thank you so much. You would watch some Call of Duty with me and other people. Well, you could be involved too, Cole. You wouldn't just have to watch. We could play some duty together too. I just want to get all the bouncing Betty, dude. I gotta clip that and post that. That was so last night. Me and Drew were playing Call of Duty, and the first game that we won, he threw a frag grenade and killed somebody and won the game. And then the game after that, right after that, I had a couple proximity mines down, and the last guy ran into those and got killed, and we won two games in a row with tactical weapons. So yeah, we definitely gotta get the Call of Duty stream rolling, because it's been a lot of fun. I feel like I've calmed down enough to the point where I'm not getting like, you know, I'm not letting the game affect my day as much. Rosie might argue with that a little bit, but I'm doing my best to calm down playing games. So, you know, I think we're going to try to add that a little bit, maybe get a little cross-community action going down. And shit, I'm just rambling on at this point. People are still interacting, though, so, you know, we're still streaming. We're out here. But we are going to end the stream now. I hope you guys have a wonderful evening. Fortnite days are behind us all. Yes, they are. I don't think I'll be playing Fortnite anytime soon again. That was a rough go for me the last time, but definitely some Call of Duty. I appreciate you guys. We'll talk to you later, and hope you all have a solid evening. My headphones are all fucked up now, so I definitely gotta end this shit. I get hyped up, but I don't, you know. I try not to let it affect my day. I said I try. I'm trying my best. I said I try, man. I'm doing my best to change. It's not easy. I got a lot of bad habits, but we're out here working on it.